Hello and welcome to the Fixit Shed. Today we've got a water neutralizer or an acid neutralizer, and it needs to have some calcite added to the system, and I thought I'd show you that process. So some things that you're going to need, you're going to need a 5-gallon bucket and a hose to siphon off some of the water out of the tank. And if you have a port in the front of it, a pair of pliers might come in handy for opening and closing the port. I do not have one of those, so we're going to be going in through the top. Also, a funnel for adding the media and some towels maybe if you spill some water on the floor. So, as you can see, if you use a flashlight, the light shines through the tank and you can see where the level of the calcite medium is. So I'm going to mark this with a piece of tape, and then when I put a bag of calcite in it, I'm going to measure how far up it went. Okay, so that's my starting point.
The first thing that we're going to do is we're going to shut the valves off, but we're turning them off to the tank, but this crossover right here is going to allow the water to continue to flow through the house, so I'm not really shutting off the water to the house at this point.
There, let's loosen these. I'm just going to walk this out a little bit so that I have a little bit more room.
Alright. So this doesn't seem to want to turn. Let me see if I can persuade it a little bit.
This is moving. It's on there pretty good. There we go. Okay, so this pipe that's sticking up is what the water comes in, and it goes down this pipe and it goes down to the bottom of the tank, and then the water filters back up through the calcite medium and then it comes back up into the head and out through the pipe that goes into the house. Okay, now we need to siphon out some of the water into the bucket. So I'm just going to put this hose in here. Okay, you can see the water level is dropping. It's down to about here.
So this pipe feels like it has like some Vaseline or something on it. I'm going to clean it off a little bit, and then I'm going to plug it up so that when I put the funnel in there, I can plug this up, and then I don't have to worry about getting any of the calcite into that pipe. Yeah, okay, I just took a paper towel and kind of wiped that off a little bit. Okay, and in the head unit here, I'm going to turn and take that out, and I think I'm going to clean out in there a little bit too. Yeah, there's an O-ring in here. So I've got some petroleum jelly. I'm going to put that in there when I put it back on, and there's an O-ring here too, so I'll put some petroleum jelly around that too.
Okay, setting jelly on O-rings. Okay, now put this part back on. Twist it, lock it into place. So now you can see how full it is there. I'm going to mark that with a piece of tape also. Okay, so about 10 inches down from the top is full. You don't want to go put any more in it than that. And one bag of calcite raised it 13 inches. So then 13 inches down from there, right around here, that's the low line. If I wait until the level of the calcite, which is now here, gets down to here, and then when I put one bag in, it should fill it up to here. Whole line, and then we're going to add one 50-pound bag. So now we know for next time.
All right.
Now I'm going to move this back into place. If you have a port on the tank where you've added the calcite, you're going to want to leave it a little bit loose. And then you're going to fill the tank up with water until it gets right to the edge of that, and then you'll tighten it up. Since this is my port, I don't have that option, so I had to tighten this one up now and hook it up, and it's going to fill up the rest of the way with water when I turn the valves back on. So, and then I'm going to turn the valves back on, and then I'm going to go and I'm going to run water until it comes out clear and make sure all the faucets run clear.
So I turn the water back on.
Okay, so I've let it settle for a little bit. I opened the faucets and let them run. The water is now coming out clear. The bubbles are out, so we're good to go. As you can see, we're not quite up to the full level, but I'll know where to fill it next time, how low it needs to be. This neutralizer system is a little bit different than other ones that I've seen on YouTube videos. It's a non-backwashing system. It also does not have a port for adding the calcium carbonate. You have either of those things if you have a backwash system or you have a port. You'd be sure to check out another video that will cover those topics for you, because they are different. So thanks for watching the Fixit Shed. If you enjoyed this video and got something out of it, please like it. If you would like to see more videos like this, please subscribe. Thanks. Take care.